HLModTech, and I'm here today to talk to you a little bit about LaserBond 100, dog. This is my first real project with the LaserBond 100, and the first thing they tell you is that you need to shake it for at least 60 seconds before you spray it on. When you do spray it on, you want to make sure that you have it about 6 to 8 inches away, and you need a nice, even spray. And then when you're done spraying, you need to spray it upside down to clear out the nozzle. Alright, so a couple of last second shakes, and then I'm going to put it down on this end. So all I'm going to do is go side to side and spray a nice even coat on that end. They say to make sure that you depress completely. And there's my nice even coat. No runs. It takes about 2 minutes for it to dry. You can speed it up using a hairdryer, but I'm not going to worry about that because I'm going to go over to Inkscape and I'm going to make my design right now while I wait for it to dry. I don't want to forget, though, they mentioned spraying it upside down until you get clear out of it so that you're sure that you don't clog your nozzle. So with that taken care of, let's go make a design on Inkscape. Alrighty, friends, we are in Inkscape, but I like to work with my template. I'm going to do new from template and pick Glowforge. If you don't have these templates, there will be a link up here where you can get to the video where I show you how to add the templates. Remember, my wrench is quite small and I'm simply going to put HLModTech on the wrench so that if anybody ever finds my wrench, they can get it back to me. There's my HLModTech. I want to pick a nifty font for it, so I'm going to click the font choices and I'm going to use the arrow keys to move down and find one that I like. I'm going to go back and choose this one right up here, a Haroni, which I don't know if I'm saying it right, but I'm going to say it that way anyhow. With it selected, I applied it. I'm going to zoom in quick so I can see it better just by clicking the zoom. And then we cannot bring text into our Glowforge like this. We need to click on it. And we need to choose path, and we need to do object path. That makes it usable in the Glowforge app. I do not want it to have a stroke, so I'm going to right click and I'm going to say set the stroke to none, because strokes are usually used for cutting. And then I do want it to have a fill, so I'm going to set the fill to pink. And this is just one of the colors that doesn't cut, and it's going to show up fine. I'm going to take this and ungroup it. And then I'm going to quickly select them all, and I'm going to make them one path by doing path union. The path won't be connected, but they'll at least be one item when they come in. I'm going to do file save, or file save as, and then I'm going to just put my initials, MH, and I'm going to put a 2 just in case I did this earlier. At this point, I'm going to switch to our cool Glowforge app, and I'm going to click home because I want to go back. And I'm going to upload a new design, and this time I'm going to do MH2, and I'm going to put our wrench in the Glowforge. I can now grab my little HLModTech. I can grow it, which I don't want to do. I'm going to do undo. I am going to move it so that it shows up on the wrench where I want, and then I'm going to shrink it so that it'll actually fit. Let's zoom in. I'm going to zoom in too, and then I'm going to grab the little hand so I can arrange it right where I want. This gets me a nice, good look at it. I'm obviously not using proof grade material, so I'm going to have to do all my settings manually. When I put in the settings, the first thing I'm going to do is look at the instructions that come with LaserBond 100. For speed, I'm going to put 500. I'm going to set the power of the Glowforge at 100. My wrench is approximately 10 millimeters thick, and then I am going to the highest focus setting so that we have the most lines per centimeter. This process only requires one pass. I've got it all set to go. I've got, you can see the black powder, where here it doesn't have the black powder. I'm going to just nudge it a little bit to this side. Let's click print and send it to the Glowforge. All right, so that was pretty fast. Total of 3 minutes. You may have noticed that I missed. My H is hanging over a little bit. That could be because I'm not 100% sure I planned for this to be standing on its edge when I measured it. So I might have changed the focus. So I'm going to say that was my bad. All right, friends, here comes the amazing part. When you're done, simply take it over to a sink and rinse it off. And just like that, we have got HLModTech on my wrench forever. Nothing wrong with running this down the sink. Totally safe, doesn't hurt anything. And in 3 minutes, we have got a quickly labeled HLModTech Craftsman wrench. How cool is that? Alrighty, friends, so there you got a quick tutorial on how to use LaserBond 100. You can buy this for $69.95 on their website. Total bargain for how you can use it. There's a ton of this left, and I'm just scratching the surface with what we can do for it. So stay tuned. I'll have more tutorials and hook you up. And if you found this useful, please hit that like button. If you've got a question, comment, or a suggestion, add it down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Mash that subscribe button and hit notifications if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new movie from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. And if you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge, wait, that's a different show.